Hello friends, myself Professor Narendra Katikar, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am going to discuss on topic auxiliary view. At the end of this session, the student will be able to generate the auxiliary view, as well as the student will be able to visualize the overall part geometry. Let us see, before proceeding with the auxiliary view, what are the type of part drawing representation methods. In first year engineering graphics, you might have learned about the orthographic views, where particularly the three quadrant, four quadrant, first angle and third angle, four quadrant method we had used to represent the part geometry in different number of views. For example, this is the front view. Here we are representing the top view, and besides the front view, we are representing the side view. This is the two-dimensional method for representation of any part geometry. The second method which we had come across, that is isometric drawing. The isometric drawing or isometric view representation is nothing but representing the part geometry in 2.5D manner. Even though we are visualizing the part in a 3D sense, but actually we are calling it as the isometric 2.5D drawing. This is another method of isometric drawing. Now, after these two different methods of part geometry representation, we'll proceed with the auxiliary view, and we'll discuss first of all the need of auxiliary view. Now, why to go with the auxiliary view? Whatever the constraints or difficulties come across in the representation of orthographic view will be overcome by the auxiliary view. Let us see the example of this part geometry. This is the simple part geometry which I am creating here. This is the isometric view which I created here. Now, for this isometric view, I will generate the front, top and side view. This is the direction of visualization, and let us represent here the front view. This is the front view. This is the top view. I am taking simple geometry. And let us consider the side view also. Now, we have the two distinct view representation method. One is isometric, another is orthographic. Now, for this particular geometry portion, in either of the view, the true shape is not visible. If suppose I want to visualize this particular hatch portion in either of the view in a true sense, it is not visible at all. Now, where to represent, where to show the true shape of this hatched portion? For the same, there is a need of auxiliary view. Now, let us discuss the basic of auxiliary view. For the same problem, we'll draw once again, we'll refer the same problem. Now, to get the true shape of this hatched portion, I have to visualize, I have to go the direction of vision in this particular side. Now, to observe the object from this particular side and to create the view, I have to consider one more plane, that is called as the auxiliary plane. This is the plane called as the auxiliary plane. I will label it as A1, A2. Now, I have to look from this particular A direction, and I have to draw opposite to this auxiliary plane A1, A2. Now, for the same, I am considering the first angle projection method. First angle projection method. Now, observing from the A direction and creating the view over here, which will deliver me the true shape of the inclined plane. Now, that means the auxiliary view is going to be used for particular geometries which are not parallel to either of the principal plane, that is horizontal plane and vertical plane, as well as it is not parallel so that we can get the true shape in side view also. Now for the same, we have to consider one inclined plane, that is the auxiliary plane. Now in the next slide, we'll see that how to create this particular view exactly. Now we'll see the two distinct geometries, the same geometry. This is the isometric view of the part. For this, I have to consider front and top view. This is the direction of visualization, x from the x. I will create the front view over here. And I will create the top view over here. Now I have to look from this side and I have to generate the view to this side. Let us consider the auxiliary plane A dash. Now how to proceed for that? I have to take the projectors perpendicular to the auxiliary inclined plane. These are the two projectors. Now my geometry is simple one. We are creating the true shape of this hatched portion. Take the projectors to the opposite side of inclined plane, auxiliary plane, and now I have to transfer the distances. Now for that, which particular reference I should take? There are two to three alternatives. One is I can take the advantage of axis symmetricity. From this axis symmetricity I can transfer the distances. Or second one is I can take this xy plane as a reference, or geometry side itself as a reference, PQ. Now we'll go here with the reference xy. Now which distances are required to be transferred? For that, let us label the points first. This is the point 1, 2, 3 and 4. So projection of 1 and 4 point into the front view 1 dash 4 dash. Projection of the point in the front view 2 dash 3 dash. Now taking the projection to create the auxiliary view, here I am taken. Now transferring the distances from xy. To transfer the to plot the point number 1, I will take this distance. Let us say this as a M. Now the same projector is coming over here, coming over here. Now from xy to point number 1 is M. Now from A1 A dash to point number 1 is M. I will transfer this distance to this distance. I will get 1 double dash. Similarly, for point number 4, I will take the distance from this total distance, say N. Now same way from A dash, I will take this projection up and fourth point projection is here. So this is the fourth double dash and this distance is N. Likewise, I will cover the four distinct points, that is 2 double dash and 3 double dash. So once I join these all four points, the geometry is created with of true shape. This is of true shape. Likewise, for distinct geometries, I can transfer the distances and I can get the true shape. Considering, suppose, hole over here, this is a cylindrical geometry. I have to divide the circle in 6 to 12 equal parts. I have to take the projectors over here. I can take it down over here. And the projected geometry may be the ellipse one. So this is the overall idea about the auxiliary view, where the most advantageous point is getting the true shape of inclined. References for this particular session is Machine Drawing by Siddheshwar Shastri, Machine Drawing by P.S. Gill. Thank you.